She Always Pleases Her Passengers, written by Duck Show Studios. Daisy the diesel rail car loves pulling passengers, and they're always pleased with their journeys.
Come along, please, and you've never ridden on quite an up-to-date diesel rail car such as myself. Unless you're a regular, then maybe you're a fan, ooh,
said Daisy. She is very kind to her passengers, and they're always happy with their journey. But she's not as kind to the other engines.
Oh, look how ugly you and your dirty trucks look compared to me and my passengers.
Oh! Daisy!
Daisy. Yes, Daisy always pleases her passengers. But one day, Duck puffed into the station with his two auto coaches, Alice and Mirabel. All of his passengers were having a great time, except for one.
Auto coach? I'm in an obsolete auto coach. Oh, dearie dear. That's not a joke. That's not good for me. No, sir.
Oh, dear. He's still complaining, said Duck.
Daisy rushed in.
Hello, Duck. Your passengers will love riding on a diesel rail car.
Well, I think all of them will, except one.
He's been complaining the whole journey,
said Duck.
Oh, I'm sure he'll change his tune when he boards me,
said Daisy. The passenger boarded Daisy.
Oh, dear. Look at this thing. It's like a coach. But, hey, where's the engine pulling it?
I am motorized. I am a diesel rail car, Your Grace. At your service, said Daisy.
Oh, really? I was so late with that pannier that I'm here at an obsolete auto coach, and I'm here with you. This is not my day. Oh, and I have an itchy head, too, to top it all.
He scratched his head.
Oh, I'm sure he'll change his tune. I'm sure he'll change his tune,
said Daisy. She rolled along. She was crossing a bridge. Then she heard a scream.
Oh, bother! Looking down triggered my fear of heights. Now my coffee spilt all over me,
said the passenger.
And it's all your fault, Daisy.
Oh, sorry, sir. Sorry about your coffee. Was I too jumpy?
Certainly. You were definitely too jumpy.
Daisy continued on her way. She was rushing through a yard. She could hear the truck singing in the background as she rushed past it, which was on the other side of a wall.
Oh, it's far too loud for me. Why can't I get any sleep after my morning coffee?
Said the passenger.
Oh dear, you're really not having a good time.
Daisy could hear him complain.
Oh, itchy head, I wonder if I have lice,
said the passenger. When she got to her final station, he ranted.
Oh, and I spilt my coffee all over that thing's seats.
Thing,
said Daisy. Oh.
And then after that, I was afraid of the bridge, and it was too loud for me to take my morning nap after my morning coffee.
Daisy went to the sheds. She was sad.
I'm sorry for for what I said to you earlier, Ryan.
That's okay, Daisy. What's the matter? You look down at the dumps, Daisy,
said Ryan.
Oh, there was this grumpy, grumpy passenger. He was complaining. He thinks it's my fault. He's afraid of heights. Oh, bother. And then he spilled his coffee all over me, and it's still on me. It's sticky,
said Daisy.
And then he thinks that the trucks were too loud. That's not my fault. And I always please my passengers, but not today.
Daisy was sad all night. Sir Topham Hatt came to see her the next morning. "What's the matter?" he said.
"Oh,"
and she told him. "Oh, it was him again," said Sir Topham Hatt. "Oh. The Thin Controller knows him well. He's always grumpy. It was nothing you did, Daisy."
"Well, he did spill coffee all on my seats. Who does that? So undignified."
And that's the end.